I'm in Ephesians 6th chapter. And the verse assigned to me is verse number 13. But in order to deal with verse 13, I think the way that it should be, I need to start at verse 10 and read from there. The Bible says, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day. And having done all, to stand." This is a great text, and it teaches us many things. We realize that in the book of Ephesians, Paul talks about a lot of things. He talks about our relationship with Christ Jesus and our salvation. He talks about our duties as children of God. He lets us know what we are to do in order to make it into heaven. Someone has already talked about unity and being unified among one another, being unified as a universal body of believers, and we need to do that. He teaches us on the subject of husband and wife relationships, and we know the importance of that. If you're married, you know that the husband and wife relationship, it can be a sweet relationship, and also it can be a relationship in turmoil. It can be a heaven on earth, or it can be a hell on earth. But the Apostle Paul lets us know our roles in marriage and how we are to act. And also in the 6th chapter, he lets us know that children are to be obedient to their parents. They are to honor their fathers and mothers, and he lets us know that that fathers ought not to provoke their children to anger, but bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. But then he comes and he says, "Finally, my brethren." But in verse 13, he says, "Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day. And having done all to stand," then he goes and he says, "Stand therefore. But my subject is, the days are evil, just stand." In order to stand in the evil day, you have to understand the preparation that you have to make in order to stand. You can't just go out and stand if there is no preparation. If I was going to fight against someone that knows karate and taekwondo and all of that, if I was going to go and compete with someone of that stature, then before I compete, I would have to learn taekwondo. Right. I would have to learn karate, whatever it is, in order to get in the battle and make the battle one that's competitive. Because if I haven't prepared myself, then the battle is not going to be a competitive one. And so the Bible tells us here, "Take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day." And so we need to look at start at verse number 10 following in order to see what the Apostle Paul is trying to get over to us as children of God. We won't dwell on these points. We'll just mention them and go on. The Bible says, "Finally," I think Brother Clemens did a great job in letting us know what "finally" means. He says, "My brethren," all of them were children of God. He said, "Be strong."
Right.
"Be strong." When we think about the word be strong, it means to make strong. It means to endure with strength. And the idea is here is to be clothed, is to clothe oneself with strength as one put on a garment. And so we are supposed to be clothed with strength in order to fight the good fight of faith. In order to be ready to stand in the evil day, we as children of God must clothe ourselves with strength and be strong as we clothe a garment. But the Bible lets us know that this strength is not in ourselves. A lot of times we as children of God, when we have problems and we have difficulties, when we are going through things in our life, we try to mount an attack in our strength. But the Bible says, be strong in the Lord and also in the power of His might. And so the power is not ours, the power is with God. And when we accept that power from God and realize that He is fighting with us, then we are able to overcome in the evil day. But if we don't, then we will not be able to overcome. And then in verse number 11, he says, put on the whole armor of God. First, be strong. Now what I want you to do, I want you to put on. And what he means here in the word put on, he means that I want you to hide in what you are putting on. I want you to hide yourself in what you are putting on. I want you to be clothed with what you are putting on. And so if you hide yourself in what he wants you to put on, if you're clothed with what he wants you to put on, then Satan is not able to get a hold on you. Satan is not able to get his claws in you. Why? Because you have the strength that God has given you. And then you have put on what he wants you to put on. And what he wants you to put on in this verse, he says, put on the whole armor of God. And so he says, I want you to put on God's armor. I want you to clothe yourself in God's armor, not your own armor. Because if you do that, then you're not going to be able to stand. And what he means literally is to put on all of the weapons. All of the weapons that God has given you, I want you to put them on. Be fully armed to the teeth with that heavy armor as a soldier in order to be able to withstand during the evil days. Then he goes on and says, against the wiles of the devil. And what he means by that word is that he means by that word the cunning arts of the devil, the deceit, the craft, the trickery, the strategy of Satan. He says that you need to be ready to stand.